Hey everybody, today I'm comparing some of the best VR headsets for phones that are cheaper than the more expensive VR headsets that have a built-in screen and sensors, like my Oculus right back there. Today I've got the Bnext and the Atlasonix brands. These are practically identical products. We have the Destek model here, and this one over here is going to be the Feebz model. Let's get right into it. So I'll start with the Bnext and the Atlasonix. As I mentioned, they're practically identical. Now the material quality is decent and they're actually pretty lightweight, which feels good when you're wearing them for a long period of time, but there are some obvious drawbacks. So one is they use this old sliding style tray for inserting your phone. The problem with this style is that it's really hard to keep the phone centered once you close the slider. So if it moves just a little bit, the visual looks blurry and you need to repeat the process and be careful about it so you can get it perfectly centered. Another concern is that the side buttons of the phone are getting pressed against the slider. So to solve this, both brands supply you with these small foam chunks here. You can stick these on the side of the slider to create a little space for the buttons, but really it's just a chunky and uncomfortable solution. It also makes it difficult to use with more than one phone because the buttons on every phone are located on different parts of the phone. Last is the remote. While both brands have models that come with a remote, I personally wasn't able to use it. It doesn't really connect to iPhones, and even on my Android, it doesn't function with the VR apps. It really just lets you control the phone volume. Luckily, most of the VR apps don't require a remote, but it's still kind of disappointing and it gets your hopes up for no reason. Next is the Destek, and this model does have one that comes with a remote as well. Unfortunately, the connectivity issues are similar to the other one. I downloaded a bunch of different apps and the remote didn't work with any of them. And if you look at the product reviews, it pretty much confirms that. But on the bright side, this model has a much easier insertion technique. So instead of an inserting slide tray, this one has a flip down version right here. It makes it a lot easier to get the phone into the headset. And this also creates space for the buttons, so easy to insert, easy to use. Last is my favorite of them all, the Feebz headset. Now, like other brands, they do have a model that comes with a remote. I chose to get the one without because I'd noticed a nice built-in solution that I hadn't seen before. So on the bottom, they have this built-in button. So the button at the bottom of the headset simply allows you to touch the screen while the phone is inside the headset, which is enough for all VR apps that I've seen until now. So no need for a remote, batteries, connectivity. So for example, if you're playing a shooting game and you need to touch the game in order to shoot, right, you can have your finger on the button and turning, and as soon as you turn, press and shoot, it's gonna make the gameplay a lot quicker and more precise for you. This makes it a great solution that always works. It also has the flip down solution for getting your phone into the headset, obviously a lot easier than the sliding trays that we talked about earlier, but there's something else that makes this the winner. One of the challenges when you're new to VR, or if you gift this to somebody for the first time, is knowing what VR apps work best with your phone and the headset. So what this brand did here, besides the clear instructions, is we've got this QR code right here that you're gonna be able to scan, and it's gonna take you to a nice looking website that has a video tutorial on how to use the headset and a list of free VR games and videos. And look at that, we're right on their site. We've got lots of recommendations for VR experiences along with different apps. They even have these small indicators telling you what the genre of the app is, if it requires a button at all, or if it's completely controller free. And there's even download links for both iOS and Android. This is great value and it shows me that the brand has done its homework and made sure we can really enjoy the VR experience. Definitely best money for value headset, and this is gonna make a perfect gift, and you'll know that the person getting it is actually gonna enjoy it. I'm actually tempted to get the remote version of this to try it out, so look for another upload video for that when I get around to reviewing it. So in conclusion, if you're looking for a VR headset that uses a phone, especially if it's going to be a gift to a kid or someone new to the VR scene, then the Feebz headset is the one that delivers. I'm real happy with it, and that's today's winner. If you enjoyed my comparison video, please like and subscribe so you don't miss the next one.